What's up everybody? Sliva Ellis here. Thanks again for watching and welcome to my new subscribers. If you're new to my channel, I'm trying to bring you cryptocurrency news in an entertainment kind of way, so it's easy for you to digest. So today, I wanted to talk about Changely and their servers. Poor servers actually. But before we start over to that, I just wanted to comment to some comments that has been placed on yesterday's video about when is the bubble about to burst. Yeah, so basically there were some people commenting like, you know, the crypto market is still in its early stages, and if you compare it to the derivative markets with a size of 555 trillion, you know, that's the bubble that's gonna burst. I'm not denying that. That's true, and that will have a big impact on the world economy. But there are big bubbles and there are small bubbles, right? And I'm just saying, I have the feeling we are in the euphoric stage right now. That's the sentiment that I feel around me without the new money coming in. I mean, you know, now, let's not forget, it took a lot of years to get to the 10 billion, and now it took 1 year to get to the 20 billion, and now it's exploding to the 80 billion, right? But still, if you have the geek money that's getting out because they have cashed out at the early stage, then there's still a chance that the bubble might burst. Might that happen anytime soon? No. I mean, an euphoric stage can also take a while now, especially now, when it first go to the stage that the hedge funds are getting in, forex traders are getting in, the next stage is that more and more of the mainstream and average Joe are getting in, right? And if we look at the innovation adoption curve, so someone was telling me we are still in the early majority phase. I don't think we are yet, you know? If we look at that curve, it starts with the innovator stage, which is 2.5% of the total group. Then you have the 13.5% of the early majority. And I don't have the feeling that we are in the phase yet of the 13.5%. And I'm even doubting if we are already in the 2.5%. So I think we might be even in the pre-innovator stage or in the early stage of the innovator phase. So yeah, still, there is still a lot of room to grow. But let's see. Only time will tell. And I don't know if you double checked, or maybe it's because my mother tongue is not English, but I made a reference to the magnitude of size of the tulip bubble and what kind of impact it had on the Dutch economy. And I was making a reference to the magnitude of the dot-com bubble that it had on the full Nasdaq. So that's on a more bigger proportional kind of scale. But still, markets react like this. And after each bubble, there is a rise again. That's how the market works. So maybe now, with the new money coming in, the burst will not be as bad as in 2013. Of course not, because the volumes are far more bigger than back then. But yeah, that's it. That's what I wanted to say about that. But again, I'm not a financial advisor. I'm just a hobby investor. Don't take anything I say for granted. Do your own research and make your own decisions. By the way, did you got into Straders and Waves when I first start talking about it? It gained 100%+, huh? Okay, so to the topic of today. Changely, I'm not so happy with them right now at the moment. So last Friday, I wanted to convert some Ethereum Classic to NEM, and step one went okay, step two went okay, and the last step where Changely need to transfer their NEM to my wallet didn't got completed. And it was giving me a message like, yeah, for small or for large amounts, blah blah blah, there can be issues. So I was like, is this a big amount then? It was only like 200 Ethereum Classic. So the message said I should try to do the transaction again. But I looked at my Ethereum Classic wallet and my coins were not refunded. So I've sent them a mail last Saturday indicating that I've done large amount of transactions in the last weeks and I didn't got any response so far. So yesterday I sent them a reminder with a transaction ID and the details and also a reference to all the transactions that I did in the last weeks. So that 200 Ethereum Classic is just pocket money if you compare it to the transactions that I did in the last few weeks. So, Changely, I'm tagging you in Twitter with this post, and I want to be a supporter of Changely and even an ambassador in that sense. But if this kind of customer service is happening in this way, then I would never recommend Changely to anybody right here. So I should have maybe been listening to David Allen, because he was also referring to this in one of his videos, that other people were also facing the same problem. So Changely, let me know your thoughts. Look back at my transactions. So these 200 ETC should be peanuts compared to the transactions that I did. So that's it for today. Thanks again for watching. Peace out.